If you watched the first two videos in this learning module, you may have noticed that I never used the word integral. You may have said, why am I calling these things antiderivatives when they're integrals? And the reason is, they're not integrals. Integrals are a whole different concept. An integral is a limit of a sum. So in this video, I want to give you a sense of what integrals and antiderivatives have to do with each other. We'll learn a lot more about that when we get to the fundamental theorem of calculus. And of course, we still have to develop the theory of what integrals are in chapter 5. So the idea of an integral is that the whole is the sum of the parts. If you've got some kind of bulk quantity, like the area under a curve between A and B, the notion of an integral is that you can take that thing, you chop it up into little pieces, you come up with a rough estimate for what's the contribution of each little piece, you add them together, and you get a pretty good estimate for the whole thing, and then you take a limit to get more and more and more accurate. Remember, the first pillar of calculus is close is good enough. So we come up with a way of getting a pretty good estimate, and then we take a limit to get the exact answer. That's what an integral is. An integral is a limit of sums. Now, that's not to say that it has nothing to do with antiderivatives. There's this amazing theorem called the fundamental theorem of calculus that says that, first of all, you can get an antiderivative by doing an integral. If you take a certain sum and take a limit, you'll get a new function whose derivative was the original function. So that's how we know that every continuous function has an antiderivative. And secondly, if you can compute antiderivatives, then that gives you a really handy tool for computing integrals. So they have something to do with each other. Antiderivatives are very useful for doing integrals, but that doesn't mean they're the same idea. Let me go by analogy. What does 2 to the 6th mean? 6 power means that this is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 6 times. And that happens to equal 64, but that's not what 2 to the 6 means. What 2 to the 6 means is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. If I ask, what is 10 squared minus 6 squared, that means something completely different. That means 10 times 10 minus 6 times 6. And that also happens to equal 64. So 2 to the 6th and 10 squared minus 6 squared mean very different things, but there happens to be a mathematical result that says they happen to be equal. Well, you should think about integrals and antiderivatives the same way. They mean totally different things. An antiderivative means a function whose derivative is the original function. An integral means the limit of a certain kind of sum. And there's this tremendous theorem, the fundamental theorem of calculus, that says that you can get one of them from the other. That doesn't mean they mean the same thing, but they are related.